Hello friends, welcome to this video program. In our earlier program we have discussed about the predictive validity of a test, how to determine the predictive validity of a test that you have prepared as a researcher or as a teacher. So in this program we will discuss about the concurrent validity, how to determine concurrent validity of a test. So friends, before discussing the concurrent validity, let me to tell once again that what are the different methods of validity that can be used for determining validity of a test. We can use phase validity method, we can use content validity method, then we can use the criterion related validity method. Under the criterion related validity method, we can use the predictive validity and we can use the concurrent validity. Then another two important method that we use for determining validity of a test is the construct validity and factorial validity. So what we will do today, we will discuss about the concept of construct validity and how construct validity is used to determine the validity of a test. So friends, before discussing the concurrent validity, let me to highlight the criterion, the concept of criterion. So you see, when we are talking about discussing the definition of validity, I have highlighted that in the definition it was clearly mentioned that your test result will be correlated with the external criterion. Okay, external criterion. So what are these criterion? Let us try to understand the concept of criterion related validity focuses on a set of external criterion. External criterion may be data for concurrent information, means data that will provide you about your test, that is the concurrent information, or of a future performance. You see, the word, the term concurrent has been taken from current. Current to concurrent means the present status or present situation of your test that you have prepared. You have prepared a test, and whether at present, means whether that test is having the value or having the quality, having the concurrent quality or not, whether this can be used at the present time or not. So that you have to determine by using certain criterion, external criterion. We will discuss further that what are the external criterion. The next is the future performance. So again, you have to establish certain criterion to know the future performance of your test, that we have already discussed in the predictive validity, that we had taken the example of a B.Ed. entrance examination. So when you compare the result of B.Ed. entrance examination with the degree, you can say the score of the students in the annual examination results, then after the second criteria is whether those have successfully completed the B.Ed. program, whether they got a good placement within a couple of years or not, and then after who got a good placement, whether they have proved themselves they are a good teacher or not. So these are the external criteria, but we have already discussed. So now we will focus on the criterion, the concurrent validity, means how to proof your test is having the concurrent validity. So friends, concurrent validity refers to the extent to which the test scores correspond to already accepted measures of performance. Okay, so try to understand these lines. Concurrent validity refers to the extent to which the test scores correspond to already accepted measures of performance. You see, you are a researcher, you are going to develop a test, maybe a test of intelligence, maybe a test of achievement, maybe a test of aptitude or creativity, okay, any test. So you see, you are not the only one person, you are not the first that you are going to develop such a test, or you are going to standardize that test, or you are going to find the validity, determining the validity of the test. You will find that such type of test have already been developed, okay, maybe by other researchers, maybe by other teachers, maybe by other experts, And you will also find a very good test which is having the quality of universal use, that can be used in any situation, or you can say that can be used in any culture. Okay, so maybe personality test, maybe you can say achievement or intelligence test. So what you will do, the test that already has been established, that already has been used many a time and having a type of faith, and the test which is giving a consistent result, a valid result earlier, means already the reliability and validity have been established, norm have also been established on the same test. So what you will do, you have to correlate that test with your test. Let's take one example. You want to develop a test of intelligence of any age group students. Let you take the 9th and 10th standard students, or you can say the 14th and 15th age group students. You want to develop an intelligent test to measure the intelligence of 9th and 10th standard students, or it will say their age group, that is, you can say the 14th and 15th age group students. So what you will do, you see the general items, or you can say the components for developing an intelligent test is, you can take certain question from reasoning, you can take certain question from different subjects, you can take certain question from languages, okay, you can take certain question from general knowledge and general awareness, okay, you can take question certain which having certain develop certain analytical skill, you can say the questions related to inductive and deductive reasoning. So such type of questions you can take for preparing an intelligent test, and your focus should be that you should take the items which is fit or which is as per the mental standard of 9th and 10th standard students, or you can say as per the mental level or mental standard of 14th and 15th age group students. So what you will do, you have to take, by considering different reference material, you can say curriculum of the 9th and 10th standard students, you have developed an intelligent test. Okay, and what you will do, for knowing the concurrent validity of your test, whether the present status of your test, whether that test is giving a concurrent result or not, what you will do, you have to take another test which has already standardized by other authors, other researchers. I'm taking a very standard test that is developed by Bina and Simon. The standardized test of intelligence developed by Bina and Simon. Okay. So here you see Bina and Simon's test of intelligence is a very standard test that can be used in any situation. Okay. And that test is having an universal acceptance, that can be used in India, that can be used in any other country, in any situation. Okay. So what you will do, you have to select a group of students first, group of subjects first. As that test, that the test that you have developed, that is for 9th and 10th standard students. So you have to select a group of students, those are in 9th and 10th standard, or whose age group is 14th and 15th. So you have to administer both the test, meaning the test, first test that you have developed, and the second test which has already developed, which is a standardized test whose reliability, validity, norm, objectivity and usability has been established. Okay. I was taking the example of Bina and Simon's test of intelligence. And you can also observe that what are the components of your test and what are the components of Bina and Simon's test. Okay. So if it is you will find that more or less similarity, then you can use that test on the same age group, on the same group of students. So what you will do, the test result after administration, the test result of your test that you have developed and the test result of the test what the Bina and Simon has developed, you have to compare, you have to find the correlation between the two sets of scores. And if the coefficient correlation is greater than 0.5, okay, then, or you can say if it is positive and high, let it is 0.75, let it is 0.85, let it is 0.92. So you can say your test is having the concurrent validity, because you have linked your test, you have correlated your test result with a test which is highly accepted, which is a highly standardized test, which is universally used test. You see, the Binet and Simon, when developed their test, what effort they might have done, okay, for the sample size and the work that they have done for developing that test. And you as a teacher, you as a researcher, you have developed a test, you are getting a result that you are getting a positive correlation of your test result with the test result of Binet and Simon. So you can say that your test is having a concurrent validity. That test can be used and that test can be prescribed for the use of other students. So friends, in this way you can develop concurrent validity of a test. Earlier we had discussed about the predictive validity. Today we discuss about the concurrent validity. In our next program, we will discuss about another two methods to determine the validity of a test, that is the construct validity and the factorial validity. Thank you.